So good to have Miss Adrian Ross is in the house. Woo-hoo. So glad she's here, and I'm glad the rest of you are here today. We're going to have a great, great time in the Lord. How many come ready to receive whatever you have need of from God? Matter of fact, how many of you have a need that you're believing God to meet this morning? Well, we're standing with you. I didn't find this out till the other day, but somebody told me that last Sunday morning in the course of worship, one of the women in the house had a tumor on her. I believe they said it was on her side. And while we were worshiping, that tumor left. So we give God praise for that. Hallelujah. I'm here to declare to you, Jesus is in the house. His power is here. He's present to save, heal, and deliver, and meet whatever needs you have. Come on, let's lift our hands to heaven. Father, what a great day. What a great morning. What a beautiful time you've given us. And Lord, we have just come to celebrate you today. Father, to lift you high, to glorify you, to magnify you. God, I'm believing that every person in this room, God, they're going to be touched by your mighty hand and your power this morning in Jesus' name. Turn around to somebody and say, you better be ready to receive. Come on, let's do it.
Hear it, bring him every prayer so clear. tears wiped away, we'll know no sorrow. So worship Him with joyful sound. Sing until your voice gives out. No matter where or who's around, release your worship.
Worship Him with joyful sound.
Worship Him with joyful sound. Sing until your voice gives out. No matter where or who's around, release your worship.
Let's praise Him.
Praise Him like we're there in glory. Here and now He's just as holy. Jesus, You're so
Hallelujah.
are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
Sing all the saints.
To lift your hands to heaven. There's not a greater worship that can come up than the fruit of your lips to give him praise. I want every voice to be lifted up. Come on. In this room, I want you to worship him. Come on. Jesus, come on. Pick it up where it can be heard. Pick it up where it can be heard. We worship you, Jesus. We both saramande be shama bokoya.
You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things. To you. worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all.
Yes, you are.
For from you are all things. To you are all things. You deserve the glory.
Come on, I want you to put your hands together and a shout of praise to the King of Kings, to the Lord of Lords, to the Lord of Lords. To the Lord of Lords, He's worthy. He's worthy of it all. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Mande bebo sarra mando bo santere. Karene shanano bo sarra mande. Manene sharama mondere sharama koramande ye shama mama mama ramandere shama koya yondere ne shama koya mande karama sonde beke basote de kokuya. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. He's here, church. He's here. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We give you all the praise, Jesus. We give you all the praise, Jesus. Manene bosa ramande besha. Manene ne shamando brando bosama. Yeah. Jesus. We sang the song a while ago that decreed these are the days of Elijah, and these are the days of Ezekiel, and these are the days of David, that the temple of God would be restored. I'm telling you, the fire of God has been poured out upon the earth. Ezekiel released the glory and the power of God upon the earth. It was Isaiah. Isaiah said, I see him coming in all of his splendor and all of his glory. But David opened up a way that all men of every color and every walk of life could come before the Lord purely into the very throne room of God. And I'm here to declare to every one of you in this place this morning, you have a right to uphold and obtain everything that is in the hand of God. It is yours. For those that will open up their heart and open up their life and just receive it and just take of it. It's yours today. Hallelujah. This is the day of His great power. It's the day. It's already been poured out. Pentecost opened up. This is Pentecost weekend. It opened up the heavens. The glory and the power has been released, and the power of God isn't coming down. The power of God is in His church, and He's waiting for His church to release His power and release His glory. Hallelujah. Glory. I don't know about you. I don't know what you came to get. I didn't come because it was Sunday morning. I came because I have need of Him, and I come to worship Him and receive of Him, and I'm believing Him this morning. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm ready to receive all that He has. Before you're seated, I want you to turn around and greet two or three people that are here this morning. Tell them you're glad to see them. Would you do that? Then you can be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, God. Hey, Larry, would you bring me my Bible there for a moment? I'm telling you, it's time to receive. Just my Bible. It's time to receive. Come on, I want you to worship with me. I'm trying to get on with something else. But I sense the presence of the Lord. I think this is a good time right here. If you come looking, if you've got a need, I want you to tell him, Master, I have need of you to touch me here. This is what I need from you this morning. Father, we believe. Father, we believe. Oh, we believe, Jesus. I got to get out of the way, because I want Steve to release what he's got. Good morning, everybody. So good to see all of you today. I'm so glad you're all here this morning. Welcome. So good to see all of you. Smile at your neighbor real pretty and say, I'm glad I get to sit next to you today. This is the first Sunday of June, and this is our birthday Sunday that we honor all of you that have a birthday throughout the month of June. If you do, would you mind standing to your feet? We just want to acknowledge you and bless you. Just stand to your feet. I see little hands. I see you back there. All of you, bless you. So glad. Just stay on your feet for just a few moments. Just stay up, because we want to bless you this morning. I want to give you this passage of scripture that keeps coming to my heart for you out of the book of Psalms 139 in verse 13. It says, For David said, for you formed my inner parts, and you covered me in my mother's womb. And I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. And marvelous are your works, and that my soul knows very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret and skillfully wrought in the lowest part of the earth. Your eyes saw my substance, being yet unformed, and in your book they are all written, the days fashioned for me, when as yet there was none of them. I declare over you this morning that you are fearfully and wonderfully made by the hand of God, and that you are perfect as you are in his sight. And your very existence, your very movement, delights the heart of God. Matter of fact, I saw it like this. When my kids and my grandkids come in, Miss Judy, it does something to my heart. And I'm telling you, if it does something to our heart like that, what it does to God's heart every morning when you get up and you throw your hands up to him and say, Jesus, I love you. I'm telling you, you are a delight to the heart of God. So stretch your hands towards him. We bless you to walk in this new year of your life. We bless you with health and wholeness and peace and joy. We bless you to walk in the presence and the glory of God, and that you will have more than what you could ever imagine. And life will be full. There will not be a dull day in your life this year. We declare that. We bless you with that today in Jesus' name. Come on, let's give them a big hand this morning, would you? You guys can be seated. We might as well have Pastor Val and Miss Sherry stand up. Today is their 52nd wedding anniversary. Stretch your hands towards them. We bless you guys today on this 52nd day. What a model that you have been to countless numbers, and you have been to us in your life and in your marriage. But we bless that these next years, these greater years, are going to be full of more love, more passion, more desire, more glory than what you could ever imagine, more health, more peace, more rest than you could ever want in Jesus' name. Amen. We love you guys. Give them one more hand, would you? Wow. God is good, isn't he? Well, stand with me one more time. We're going to receive our offering We're going to release our kids in just a moment to let them go. But this is a moment that we're going to honor God with our first fruits, the first of our increase, so that our barns are filled with plenty and our presses will burst with new wine. I couldn't help but think about this morning, Miss Judy. I was reading from the book of Deuteronomy when God brought the children out of Israel. He said, I'm bringing you into a land that flows with milk and honey. You'll have houses you didn't build. You'll drink from wells you didn't dig. You'll have bread that you eat to the full. Why in the world would I want to hold anything back from God when God has already made me a promise that I will have more than enough? I will have a sufficiency of all things. That's His promise to you today. So, Father, I bless your people as they give. I declare they're the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, blessed coming in, blessed going out, when they rise up, when they sit down. Father, I thank you that when the enemy comes against them one way, he's got to flee from them seven. And I thank you that you have already commanded the blessing upon their storehouse, and everything they put their hand to shall prosper in Jesus' name. Amen. Come ahead and bring your offering as they continue to worship.
It's yours, God. All of the praise, all of the praise, all of the praise.
Going to release our children to go out this morning. Miss Noel, wherever they are going that way, I think there she is. She is out of spot this morning, but they're going that way. They're in a good, safe place back there. They're going to be ministered to. One quick announcement before I bring our guests. This is our last day to sign up for Forward Teenagers. I hope all of you will plan to go. And also, Alexis is wanting to meet with all the fam. That's my daughter-in-law. They want to meet with all the parents, I think, on Wednesday night to give you an update of everything that's going to go on and forward in just a couple of weeks. Well, I'm so blessed and honored this morning to have our guest, Steve Sampson. He's not a stranger to us. He's been in our world for, 35 years or better. He just celebrated 50 years of ministry just a couple of months ago. Yeah, praise God. He stands as an overseer to this house. He's been a friend to us. He's been with us in our good times. He's been with us in our bad. And I'm just honored. I believe it's the will of the Lord for him to be here this morning and also tonight at 6. So would you make Steve Sampson welcome as he comes this morning?
Amen, amen. Everyone have a seat, please. We're just here to enjoy the Lord. I'll tell you, there's no one I like better who leads worship. He takes us, pastor takes us into the presence of God. I love it, and I love the way he always gets us in that throne room. And I love the sensitivity to the Holy Spirit. And yes, we've known each other for many moons. I know Stacy was 9 years old, I remember, or six, maybe, but she was smaller then. And so many good memories. I'll tell you, there's nothing like the body of Christ. You know, I've always said God is not looking for worship. He's looking for worshipers. If he was looking for worship, he could buy a CD. But he's looking for worshipers. When I first got filled with the Spirit, the Lord said, because I battled depression, he said, you can't sing and be depressed at the same time. So I said, well, what about country western? And he didn't answer. He didn't answer. So anyway, oh, man, what a glorious day. And I feel like I'm right in the timing of God being here. And I have a friend that the whole topic this morning is receiving. And I bet pastors use the word receive about 400 times. But I really feel that God is saying 24/7, he's committed to getting you to receive. God wants us to receive. And let me just read this from John chapter 1. He was in the world. The world was made through him, and that the world did not know him. He came unto his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right, the authority, to become the children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of the blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. He came into his own, and his own received him not, but as many as did receive him, he gave them power to become. Could I get you to say a sentence with me? If you're not receiving, you're not becoming. We have to receive from God 24 hours a day. That's why he says in the Lord's Prayer, give us this day our annual bread. Give us this day our daily bread. It should be normal to hear from God. It should be normal to experience the prompting of the Holy Spirit. It should be normal to have revelation, understanding, God's thoughts pouring in. Because I promise you, God is wanting us to receive. Jesus stood at the, sat on the hill of Jerusalem. And he said, oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, this is Luke 13, the one who kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to her, how often I wanted to gather your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, but you were not willing. See, your house is left to you desolate, and assuredly I say to you, you shall not see me until the time comes when you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. God wants us to receive. How many believe Jesus paid it all?
Yes, sir.
Then there's nothing left for you to do. It's finished. He's paid it all. There's only one thing left to do, is to receive. Now, most Christians, many Christians, misunderstand, and they're trying to perform. God doesn't need your performance. He performed it all on the cross. He said it is finished. Literally translated, it is completely complete. So there's nothing left for you to do except respond. Don't try to perform. Respond. I've been thinking of a lot of the word lately, marinate. I'm not a good cook. I mean, I can't cook. I had four sisters. I was raised on a farm. I cannot cook, but I can shovel manure. I'm good at that. But I asked my wife about the word marinate. She said it adds flavor, adds tenderness. And I believe, and this is what God's been speaking to me, it's not enough just to come in to pray. We need to marinate. Don't just pray, marinate. Wait for God to impart to you. Wait for God to speak to you. That should be a normal thing, because the Holy Spirit has an agenda. Now, let me tell you something about him. He will not yell at you. He will not scream at you, but he will talk to you. But his voice many times, most times, is very slight. It's very faint. I've learned something. The God and the devil are looking for the same thing. God wants you to receive, and the devil wants you to receive or agree with him. God wants you to agree with him. The devil wants you to agree with him. They're both looking for the same thing. I'll say it this way. God is committed to us that we receive. The devil is committed that you don't receive. So all our life, we have this thing on our shoulders here, And it's called an abortionist. It will reason away God. Sometimes we have like a spiritual ADD. We're trying to follow God, but we got, isn't that clever? That thing sparkles, and we get distracted, and we're always aiming for things, and we miss our day to receive. Sometimes it's just good to picture prayer. Prayer is more about listening. It's more about paying attention. It's about being in the presence of God and letting Him speak to you. Hallelujah. So God is not impressed with performance, although that's where the religious world is. If we perform enough, then God will accept us. But the good news is He's already accepted us. I love the fact that we are accepted, because most people don't believe they're accepted. Most people have a mindset that God's against them somehow, or God is trying to hinder them. The Holy Spirit is called the Helper. He's on the earth. Jesus Christ is seated at the right hand of God, but He is the Helper on the earth. He's a good guy. I call Him a sweetie pie. He's there to help your life, to encourage your life. And so we're not trying to impress Him. We want to receive from Him. I have a friend named Kevin, and he prayed for you this morning. I pray with him every Saturday night, every Sunday morning, because he was bribed to a church. He had a friend that had done him a major favor, helping him with his mortgage once, and Kevin hated church. He hated preachers. He hated it all. He grew up in church, but he was so tired of the hypocrisy and everything. And his friend invited him to come to Lagodi, Indiana, and be in this meeting. And so Kevin says, you know, thanks, but no thanks. I don't believe it's what I want to do. But his friend said, would you do it as a favor to me? And he comes that night, and he comes in the meeting with ingrown toenails, and they're so bad he has the front of his shoes cut out because his toenails are in such bad shape. Anyway, during the meeting, God just casually healed him. And then his back had been in such pain for 18 years of their marriage. Every single morning, his wife, Debbie, with no exceptions, it took her 2 hours to get him out of bed. His back injury was so bad. Every single morning for 18 years. That night, he came as a bride. His friend bribed him to come, and God healed his back. He hadn't had a pain since. Hallelujah. Now, Kevin, who hated church and hated preachers, is now a pastor. And he literally, in Bedford, Indiana, he literally pastors the whole city because he has a big mouth and he won't stop talking about the Lord. But and there's this attitude he has to receive. And so many times we get in the presence of God and we forget we're here to receive. We're not supposed to leave here this morning the way we came. Tomorrow morning, God wants to give you something. I encourage you to journal. Write down things God talks to you. When you get in prayer, write down things. Maybe it's a thought. Maybe it's just an unction. Maybe it's a prompting. Maybe it's a scripture, but write it down, because I journal all the time, and when I don't, I'll look back a few months later and I'll see my handwriting. And I do not recognize it. I do not recognize that. My mind has totally dismissed it. I forgot what the Lord said. Maybe that's why Jesus said to the disciples, you know, they worried because they had no bread, you know, and Jesus kind of rolled his eyes and said, you know, the other day I fed 5,000 people with this 5 loaves and 2 fish, and you don't remember that? You don't remember? He said, but another, we have a tendency to forget. Because the Holy Spirit is talking to us, and there's so many abortions in the Bible. Jesus said to Peter, Luke 5, let down your nets for a catch. And Peter said, Lord, we've been out here all night. You know you're in trouble when you're giving God information. Anyway, but he said, we've been out here all night. But he said, nevertheless, at your word, I'll let down the net, even though this doesn't make sense. As a fisherman, I'll do it. And we all know all these fish tried to get in the boat, and then they had to call the Catholics in the other boats to come and to help them. And it's a wonderful story. But when it happened, this astonishing, magnanimous, amazing amount of fish. What did Peter say? He didn't say, hot dog, hallelujah, this is wonderful. He said, get away from me. I'm a sinful man. And most of us are like him. We're rejecting the Holy Spirit because we still don't know who we are in Christ. And we're saying, get away. We don't say it that way, but we're saying, God, I know I'm not worthy. And my friend says, you know, I felt so unworthy. I didn't feel holy enough to come to you, so I stopped coming to you. And the Lord said to him one day, I didn't ask you to come on your holiness. I asked you to come on my holiness. Wow. So anyway, God wants us to receive. I was at Quincy, Illinois. Pastor Zach, you've been there at that church. And there was a conference in March. And so I was asked to speak two nights there. So one night, during the flow of the Holy Spirit, there's a word. Somebody here has an eye injury. God wants to heal you. This little 12-year-old girl told her dad, she said, Daddy, that's you. But somebody else kind of jumped up. I had cataract surgery. I need healing. And it never happened. And he said the whole way home that night, the family reprimanded him. Dad, you should have gone up there. You should have gone up there. So the next night they come back. And there's another word. Somebody here, you've had surgery. And this guy jumped up. He said, I'm not going to miss it. Because he'd had a weed eater accident. And he was totally blind in his left eye. Totally blind. And it had been like 3 years. He said, the doctor has removed my eyeball at least three times. Took it out, messed with it, dipped it in something probably. And then put it back in. He said, I'm still blind. But that night, he came up. He received. He responded. We all prayed, let's all pray. And after a few minutes, can you see anything better? He said, yeah, I'm seeing. I said, how much, 10%? He said, oh no, more like 80%. And to this day, his eye is 100% healed. 100% healed. But he almost didn't receive it because there's something in all of us, as well as probably for somebody else. His 12-year-old daughter said, Dad, you know, that's you. You don't have to go around blind. This is for you. And he received it. And it's just an amazing miracle. But how many times do we abort? Remember the story of Naaman the Syrian in 2 Kings? I believe it's chapter 5. But it says that he was a leper. More or less, he had four-stage cancer. He was just a mess. And this little Israel girl said, boy, it's a shame he's not in Israel because there's a prophet over there. He'd get healed, you know. And so he writes a letter to the king, said, I'm coming over to get healed. The king gets mad, said, I can't heal. What are you doing? Anyway, it says that the prophet heard about it, and he said, tell him, send him to my house. So it's a wonderful story. So he came to his house with an entourage of people, bodyguards probably, and he pulls up in front of Elisha's house. Elisha didn't come out, but he sent a messenger out that had a bad case of acne, and he said, just threw that in. But anyway, what I'm saying is, God will use the most unlikely person to get you to receive. Yeah. Right. And so he comes out and says, the word of the Lord to you is go down in the river Jordan, dip seven times, and your flesh will be restored. Four-stage cancer. You know how he responded? He got mad. It said he went away in a rage. Why? Because he said, I thought the prophet was going to come out and like Clint Eastwood, wave his hand and leprosy would fly everywhere. Instead, he sends out this pimply-faced teenager to tell me to go dip in the river Jordan. And I'll tell you something. I got better rivers at home than Jordan. I've got rivers with stained glass windows in them. I've got rivers at home. If I want to go to a river, I'll go at home. And there were some anti-abortionists there, and they said, listen, if he had told you to do something hard, you would have done it. Since he's told you to do something so simple, why don't you do it? And they stopped the abortion. He went down to Jordan, full of ugly leprosy, nasty leprosy, and dipped. First dip, nothing happened. The seventh dip, his skin was restored like the skin of a little child.
but his brain almost aborted it.
Yeah.
And I promise you, God is telling you every day, I want you to receive.
Yes, sir.
Give us this day our daily bread and make a record of it. Don't forget it. And in fact, I've talked to Pastor Zach about this, but you know, I believe most of us hear a good sermon and we go home and we forget it. And I believe part of receiving is going back and re-listening and saying, now what was being told me? You know, and pastor had a great word Sunday morning. What is it? I can't remember, but it was good. You know, but we need to receive and digest those things that God is talking to us, because I guarantee you, your brain will dismiss it. Your brain will forget it. But we need to be more aggressive in receiving. We also need to be more aggressive in using our authority. Isn't it amazing in Ephesians 6 when he talks about the armor of God and he says, helmet of salvation, the girdle of truth, the breastplate of righteousness? But then he says something interesting. He said, above all, Ephesians 6 verse 10, above all. In other words, the most important part of your armor, above all, is take up the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench the fiery darts of the enemy.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Because that's, most of us don't do that. The devil comes along and says, you know, you're a failure. That's a confirmation. I feel like a failure. You know, and we buy into the enemy way too much. And we need to be more aggressive and say, no, I don't receive that. I don't accept that. And I replace that word. You call me a failure. I'm not only not a failure, I'm more than a conqueror. And God has amazing plans for my life. If we would do that as a lifestyle, the enemy would get away with nothing. But most of us are just wimpy that way. And I'm included. We let the enemy walk on us. When I get tormented by the enemy, I don't feel like rebuking the devil. I really don't. I feel like slapping somebody. I don't, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, I don't feel like rebuking. I'm mad. I'm upset emotionally. I don't feel like in a full of authority. But God says, above all, use your authority. Take authority over the enemy. If God be for you, who can be against you? Wow. You know what I believe? I believe if you took every word love out of the Bible and replaced it with the word acceptance, which really is the same thing, it'd be such a much better message. God loves you. Well, that sounds so generic, but to say God accepts you. He accepts you. He's not against you. He accepts you. He loves your weirdness. He loves your personality. He loves your uniqueness. He really does. And God has an amazing sense of humor. Now, with that, saying he loves you, he still thinks you're very strange. But he loves us. I have read a book recently about people that have gone into heaven and near-death experiences, and just amazing. Two or three books I've read on it. It's just amazing. But every single person says without fail, when I was in heaven for those few minutes and I saw the Lord, I came out convinced that God loves me. And there was you can't take it away. But many people aren't convinced. And the Bible says to come boldly. And the only way you can come boldly is to know you're loved.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if you feel like God's disappointed in you, if you feel like God's mad at you, you can't pray boldly. But if you know that you know God loves me. And it doesn't mean I'm perfect. I do have an odd-shaped head, but it's okay. But it's okay. Because God loves me, and you can pray boldly. And believe me, God doesn't have confidence in you personally, but he has confidence in the Holy Spirit he's put in you. Because how many know that you don't have to look far to find somebody with a need? You don't have to go overseas anymore. They're all here. You know, it's just like there's so many needs all around us, and God wants us, he wants to tap into the Holy Spirit he's put in each of us. Because it's only that flow of the Holy Spirit that's going to help anybody. And he's willing. He's paid the price. It's finished. It's completely complete. Our part is to begin to access it, to begin to enjoy it. And I mean it when I say enjoy. Most people are boring, I think. They're just boring because they don't enjoy God. But God wants us to be, I don't mean most people, but there's a lot of boring people out there. Listen to this. He says, this is Hebrews 12. See that you do not refuse him who speaks. For they, if they did not escape who refused him on earth, how much more shall we not escape if we turn away from him who speaks from heaven, whose voice then shook the earth, but now he's promised, saying, yet once more I will shake not only the earth, but also heaven. Now this yet once more indicates the removal of those things that are being shaken as of things that are made, that the things which cannot be shaken may remain. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom which cannot be shaken, let us have grace by which we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. In other words, God is building his kingdom. Probably one of the most damnable lies out there is if you, all you do is have to pray the sinner's prayer and everything's going to be fine. It's Walt Disney Christianity after that. No, after you pray that sinner's prayer, God says, he that has begun a good work in you is committed to you to perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. It may take God 70 years, but he's gonna put in you his image, and he's going to extract the hindrances. And this friend of mine that I was talking about, Kevin, he's so prophetic, and he prayed this morning, and he said, tell that church, and he's so prophetic, he said, tell that church, the floodgates have been opened. You're getting ready. You're getting ready. And I trust him. I trust his word. But he said, this church here in Cape Girardeau is getting ready to experience a flood. Hallelujah. A real flood. And sometimes you've been through some pain. We've been through some junk. But the issue is we're being made ready. God has done a work. And not for our sake, but for his sake, he's increasing his kingdom. And to think that, well, I prayed a sinner's prayer, that's just the tiny, tiny beginning. I remember when my children were born, you know, here's the delivery room, here's the recovery room, and then I wanted to say, where's the room where you raise them? Because I don't want to do this, you know. I see a little baby, and I think, that's 20 years of hard work right there, you know. And it's like, but I think that's the way God is. He said, my goal wasn't just to save you, to get you to heaven. My goal was to do a work in you, that you would become, you would take on my nature, and you would change, your life would change the world, and anybody that crossed your path would be drastically changed. So God's goal is for us to receive. I was in this church in Storm Lake, Iowa, and one night there's a word. Somebody's broken a bunch of bones because of an accident. The guy never came up. Afterwards, he comes up and says, well, I had my own personal plane. I crashed, and I broke 127 bones. I said, why didn't you come? But I don't know. I thought it was probably for somebody else. You know, we're so weird. We're so weird about receiving. We need to come with an aggressiveness. Say, God, I'll take all you have. Yeah. To me, the greatest shame is to come to church and go the way, leave the way you came. Jesus said, these people honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. And if God is doing anything today, he's telling us to start getting intimate with him. He's saying, draw near to me and listen to me. Hear my voice. And you know, just the price to pay many times is just to be silent. I know one day I was praying for myself, praying for myself, and I'll never forget it. I felt like I heard God yawn, and it was like, and it's like God saying, this is so boring, you talking about you all the time. And so I changed my policy. I said, I'm going to pray for every person I can think of, every person that comes to mind, and it's amazing how the Lord will, he'll speak to you in that. Remember that time Paul said, shall I come to you with a rod or with love and a spirit of gentleness? They probably said, well, maybe you shouldn't come at all. But I believe, if you think about it, this helper on the earth, 24/7, he's trying to get you to receive. Receive encouragement, receive strength. You know, most people don't reject God for who he is. They reject him for who he isn't. I grew up in a church that it was so legalistic, and it made me hate God. I just said, this is like the people were mean. You know, not all of them, but a lot of them were. But there was a hardness about religion. Many people who reject God, they're just really rejecting religion. They're not really rejecting God. this scripture real quickly, Luke 5. Happened on a certain day, verse 17, as he was teaching, there were Pharisees and teachers of the law sitting by who had come out of every town of Galilee, Judea, and Jerusalem. I love these words because it says, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Before I continue on, this couple right here, you guys have been, it's like you've been, I keep seeing this all morning, but it's like you've been climbing a mountain, and it's just like the battle's over, and you've reached the mark. Something so close is getting ready to manifest in your lives, and it's the Holy Spirit's doing. But he is so with you. He is so behind you. And in the near future, you're going to see so many things manifest that have been in your heart for a long time. You're almost there. That's what I hear. Wow. Hallelujah. Yeah. So this day, there were Pharisees and teachers of the law sitting by who had come out of every town, out of Galilee, Judea, and Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. I thought Jesus was mean to Pharisees. This day, God and Jesus must have had a conversation. Let's heal some strange Pharisees today. Let's heal some pointed-headed Pharisees. Let's just be different today. Let's do it. And God was present to heal them, but no Pharisee got healed because these four guys brought their friend. And their friend was so miserable. He evidently was a paraplegic. He was so desperately in need of healing. And they couldn't get in because of the crowd. And I want to tell you something about crowds. There's always a crowd to press through. The only place there's not crowds, I've found, is the salad bar and the exercise room. Everything else in life is a crowd. And these guys saw that they came to the house. Jesus is in there teaching. They couldn't get in because of the crowd. But these guys got up on the roof. Somehow they manufactured, I don't know what they did, but they got something worked up from Home Depot, and they lowered it down in front of Jesus. And what did Jesus say? Son, your sins are forgiven. They got offended, and they aborted what God wanted to do. And there was never a record of any Pharisee being healed that day, but it was God's intention to heal them. That's Luke 5. You ought to read through that sometime some more. So, remember that story about the helicopter? This guy, the flood, and the boat came by, and another boat came by, finally a helicopter. He said, no, God's going to save me. And then he went to heaven. He says, God, why'd you take me to heaven? I was asking you to deliver me. He said, I sent three people. I said, I was in a deal, working hard on a book and just doing all kinds of ministry things a couple of years ago, and I was just busy. And this real sweet couple from Waco, Texas, they're simple, but they're precious, and they have a prayer life. And they called me, and they said, Steve, if you don't mind, the Lord has given us a word for you. Could we give it to you? And I said, maybe. And they're so pure, I thought, whatever it is going to come from God. And they said, Steve, the word is real simple. The Lord said to tell you he misses you. I was working so hard, and it was all spiritual things, but the Lord's attitude was, I miss fellowship with you. God wants us to receive. I've been praying for people sometimes and just laying hands on them. And all of a sudden I feel this power, just like I'm about ready to fall over. And I used to think, boy, it's the power of God. And I've learned later, it was the power of God, but it was the power of God coming back on me because they weren't receiving. You ever prayed for somebody to receive the Holy Spirit and you start praying and they're going, no. Like, yeah, they're just, their head's going, no, no. I said, well, you blockhead. You're not going to receive shaking your head like that, for one thing. But in other words, God, and how many times in heaven is God going to say, I sent people to you so you could be baptized in the Holy Spirit, and you never received? God's, if we get this mentality today, God is 24/7. He wants you to receive. He wants you to receive good news. He wants you to receive healing. A week from now, he wants you to say, look how much I've done for you in 1 week. All you have to do is receive. Hallelujah. How many years?
52.
52, okay. I never did understand what Sherry saw in him. But I, but that's funny. Oh, man. Wow. So I want to pray for the people today who, let's just hang around for a minute here, but you have, I know there's at least one, but I think there's two or three that have bad, like headaches, like migraines a lot, and probably pretty much a daily thing, if not real frequent. But if you could just raise your hand, tell me who that is. You just, yeah. Would you run up here a second? Let me pray with you. And who else is it besides our little sister? Yeah, come up here a second. God will do it. And I know already. Where are you at? Oh, yeah, come here. I know already. Now, this sounds arrogant, but I just know because I know God. You'll never have another headache. You never will. Do you have them every day?
Oh, 15 to 20 days a month.
15 to 20 days a month. Well, that's going to be that's coming to an end. That really. What about you?
Not every day, but
a lot. A lot of days, okay. And what about you?
Not every
day. A lot.
And every day for about 2 weeks.
Every day for 2 weeks. You didn't get married, did you?
No.
No, just kidding, just kidding. What about you?
Every day.
Every day.
With vertigo.
With vertigo. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're all five going to be healed, I can guarantee you. And all we're doing is agreeing with the Holy Spirit, because I'm certainly not the healer. But I'm excited when God moves. First name again?
Tina.
Tina, sorry. Pray for my hearing. but Lord, we thank you for Tina. We thank you right now for healing her, that these headaches never return, oh God. We thank you for touching her and healing the root of this in Jesus' name. We just receive with her. We rejoice with her that you're the one that's doing this. Hallelujah. I see so many decisions coming up, and I see so many choices, like just multiple things. That God is going to make this easy. He's going to bring extreme clarity. And this sounds funny, but the rest of 22, you're going to have so much fun. Just things God's doing. And he's going to have fun with you. All right? Amen. Amen. First name?
Alyssa.
How long? You said a long time of these. Lord, we thank you for Alyssa right now. We thank you for healing the root of these headaches. So we're just in agreement with you, Lord. This is your idea. And we thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Totally. Do you have issues with your stomach as well? Yeah. Not you? Okay. Well, Lord, we thank you. We thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Does somebody close to you have trouble with their stomach? Don't know. Okay, that's all right. But Lord, we just thank you. No more headaches ever again. None. Zero. Zilch. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I see a fire being started. I feel like it's a fire in you. A fire, fire, fire of the Holy Spirit. And he's going to, it's like he's removing everything that's in your way. Everything that's, every branch in me, he said that he prunes it, he purges it, that it might bring more fruit. God's going to simplify your life. And he is going to make it, life's going to get more palatable. It's going to have a better taste to it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And your name is?
Kiva.
Lord, we thank you for healing Kiva today. We thank you for a brand new life and a brand new freedom from headaches, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we declare it. We declare it, oh God. I see you having a lot of influence on your peers. I see you with a big stick and you're stirring the pot. And what's going on in you is going to happen to others. You're not going to have to try to make it happen. But there's going to be a great stirring among friends, and you're going to be a big part of what God does in their lives. And no more headaches. Hallelujah. First name?
Jessica.
Lord, we receive with Jessica, we receive the healing power of God for her headaches no more. We declare them done in Jesus' name. We declare them over Jesus' name. Part of her history, but not part of her destiny. God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God has brought you so far, and I just feel him bragging on himself.
You just overcome addiction.
Said, yeah. God's proud of you. Hallelujah. 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 And we just thank you, Lord. That is sealed. That is sealed. That is sealed. That is sealed in Jessica. And Lord, even the desire of it will never return. And Lord, you've delivered her. And you're proud of her. And you're bragging on her, Lord. In Jesus' name, we thank you. And no more headaches. No more headaches. Hallelujah. Let's deal with your father. Do you know him at all? Is he a believer?
No.
Well, God's going to do something for him. I just feel that. So, Lord, we just claim him. What's his first name?
Michael.
Lord, we claim Michael for you. We just claim him for you. That he'll just have no choice but to turn to you, oh God. In Jesus' name. First name?
Sabrina.
Sabrina. Lord, we thank you for her. We thank you for delivering her today. And, Lord, we thank you for the work of the Holy Spirit in Sabrina's life. Lord, in Jesus' name. One thing I know, Sabrina, there's a lot of light on your path from God himself. And the Lord it's like Jabez. Lord, enlarge me, enlarge my borders, enlarge my influence. That's what God's doing for you, Sabrina. You're going to have more influence. You're going to have more results. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. I want to pray for at least one, maybe more, that have a... You're too young to have arthritis. It's like I don't know what I mean by young. Everybody seems young to me. But what'd you say? Somebody said 80. I don't know. But there's a younger person, maybe 50, I don't know. But you have arthritis, and you're too young to have it. Nobody should have it, but you're way too young. Who is that person I'm speaking? I just want to pray. Yeah, run up here a second. Yeah, you too. We just come with you. Anybody else that you're just in that category? But we're going to take authority over it. And you know what it's going to do? It's going to fade. It's just going to fade. It's going to fade. I love, because you're hearing the message today, you're receiving.
Yes.
Don't analyze. Don't say, well, it's for somebody else. You're receiving. First name is?
Gloria.
Lord, we pray for Gloria. We just stand with her and we rebuke this arthritis. We rebuke it where it began, and we just declare it dried up. We declare it cursed. In your name, and we thank you for the blood of Jesus that is against this arthritis, and we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. You recently, it seemed like months ago, had a real disappointment, but I hear God saying, there's no more disappointments.
Thank you.
He has nothing but good news up his sleeve for you.
Thank you.
First name?
Kim.
Kent?
Kim.
Kim. Lord, we bless Kim for freedom from arthritis. We bless her, God. With a understanding and a deliverance, oh God, from this in Jesus' name, that she doesn't have to suffer with this another day. We break its curse in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
You're not done.
I'm not done. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we praise you. We praise you for the work of your Holy Spirit. We praise you, God. You know, I see God sorting a lot of things out. He sorted a lot of people out of your life. He sorted a lot of issues out of your life. And I just see you. And when I hear the Lord saying, smooth sailing, you're heading in for some smooth sailing. Hallelujah. And what you've been through has been painful, but it's a God thing because he's sorting out stuff.
Thank you.
It's freedom. Freedom, freedom. Hallelujah. First name is?
Gina.
Lord, we agree with Gina. We agree in Jesus' name that this arthritis is cursed at the root. We agree that she's going to live arthritis free, oh God. And we thank you, Lord. Seems like you have trouble sleeping too. So we just agree with you about that.
Thank you.
I think I saw you sleeping over there, but Lord, we just thank you for Gina. We thank you, Lord, that she's going to sleep like a baby. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sleep. We break that spirit of insomnia off her. We declare, oh God. You know, the one sentence I hear from the Lord, your best days are ahead.
Thank you.
Yes, they are. Hallelujah. And first name?
Jennifer.
So, Lord, we thank you for Jennifer's healing today, that this is your day. You've ordained it for her to receive healing. We declare, oh God, Jennifer free. In the name of Jesus Christ, we declare her free. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. There's going to be more and more better days. There's going to be more and more higher levels. This zigzag, this emotional thing, this roller coaster, that's going to even out. And you and the Lord are having a thing going. Yes, you are. Oh, yeah, yeah. And he's right in the center of it. He's for you. He's not against you. He's 100% for you. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. So, seemed like I'm supposed to pray for somebody. You've been married 32 years. If I'm hearing the Lord at all, but 32 years right in there. Whose marriage is right at 32 years? And if you're close, yeah. Two couples here. It's good you're sitting together. That helps. If I look like I know what I'm doing, I don't. But that's the good news. We don't have to know what we're doing. We just say, Lord, because we want to receive. So we know God's going to do something fresh in your marriages right at 32?
30.
Okay. Lord, we bless Sabrina and
Mark.
Lord, we bless Sabrina and Mark today. We thank you, Lord, that they are called to encourage. You know, I see a lot of strength in you both. And I see there's been a lot of tussles with the enemy. But you're winning. And you're going to point a lot of people on the right path. You trust God, but God trusts you. God's going to entrust more people to you, more souls to you, to speak into their lives. It's not something you're going to have to make happen. It's just going to happen. But there's more virtue flowing. There's more strength flowing. There's more light coming. There's more anointing. And the way you minister to God's people, God's going to take care of all your needs. As you do God's thing, God's going to do his thing for you. Amen. Amen. 32, close?
33, as of April the
30th. As of April the 30th, so you... You just finished 22, 32.
Yes.
And how many good years was that? It doesn't matter.
33 good years.
Good years, good. Good answer, good answer. So, first name again is
Tanya
and Matt. So, Lord, we bless Tanya and Matt today. We bless them with your strength, Lord, with your delivering power, oh God. And, Lord, we just thank you. I see such a peace settling on both of you. I see such a life flow. You're living life. You're aiming for the same thing. You're hitting the same mark. You're on the same page. You're on the same paragraph. You're in tune with one another, but you're also in tune with God. And I hear the Lord saying, Claire, you're stepping into the best season of your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes.
Is there a son here we're supposed to pray about?
Dylan,
what's going on with him?
Oh, he's living large.
He's living large, yeah. Gusto-like. So, yes. Lord, we just agree for Dylan. We just agree. Today, you're doing something. Whew, why do I feel that? God, you're doing something for Dylan. We just receive and bless him, and we acknowledge your power in Dylan's life, mm-hmm. And we're expecting good news.
Yes.
That's what I hear, expect good news. Yeah, expect good news. First name?
James.
James and?
Son.
Okay. Lord, we thank you for James and son. We thank you, Lord, for the freedom you've called them into. You're not called to be like anyone else. You're called to be free. There's no pressure on you to be like anyone else. You're free to be you. And the Lord loves the way you listen. He loves the way you respond. And the Lord's getting ready to share more with you. He's getting ready to, like, I see him opening a big chest of jewels and things. He's getting ready to tell you more, to show you more about your life. And I just see you in stride with him. And there's no pressure on you to perform. All you need to do is just receive and love God back. something got broken a while back, and I don't know whether it was something between you or a child or something, but something was like a relationship was hindered. And all I know is God was there, and he's taking care of it, and the wound is healed, and you're moving on. The wound is healed. The wound is healed.
Yes.
The wound is healed. So we praise God for what he's doing. Hallelujah. Taste and see that the Lord is good. I see you both just enjoying. It's like the Lord's setting a table for you every day. And you're enjoying the food. You're enjoying what he's preparing. You're enjoying himself. And you're going to get strengthened more and more. The strength is just going to increase daily. Hallelujah. You're in a new place. Yes, you are. Amen. Amen. Wow, wow, wow. So when I'm during the worship, I'm singing, but I'm also listening because I'm receiving. And there's some things the Lord said to me. I've said some of them, but feeling I'm supposed to pray with anyone that has kidney or liver issues. And God's going to do a creative thing today in your life. So if you have kidney or liver issues, if you'll run up here. And then and by the way, there's another person that's had, you get fever, colds, you're always catching something. Your immune system is weak. If you'll come up here, God will heal you today. It's like you're always sniffling. If anything's in the air, you get it. You know, you're just, but God's healing your immune system today. So if that's you, grab a hold. What's going on, Lisa?
The doctors say that I have a tumor on my liver.
Liver.
And some nodules on my kidneys.
Okay.
And my gallbladder is full of sludge. There's all kinds of things going on, yeah. But the devil is a liar. Amen?
The devil's a liar.
That's right.
And God's full of truth.
I ain't buying it.
So, Lord, we receive for Lisa today. We just receive the healing you're declaring. We receive, oh God, the total new liver, the total new kidneys. Lord, we just thank you for her. You know, the Lord loves your big mouth. He loves your big mouth.
I'm glad somebody does.
Yeah. But it's wonderful because you don't hold anything back. You tell people, and God's going to honor that. He's going to honor your effectiveness. There's going to be more fruit and more fruit and more fruit to your account. Lord, we pray that these kidney, liver, no more issues. In Jesus' name. No more issues.
Thank
we
you.
Pray it'll be confirmed by medical science that you've done a wonderful thing.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You, Jesus.
Amen.
Woo!
Roger. Pardon?
Danny's my name.
Danny. Well, the other, and you had?
Had colon cancer.
Colon cancer, okay.
Plus I got liver, too.
Liver thing, too. Well, we're going to agree. Holy Spirit's excited. I can feel him. He's excited about this.
But I'm cured.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Lord, we thank you that Danny is cured. We thank you, Lord. He's been through all these surgeries and everything. Lord, we thank you for a brand new life. We thank you for years of life, years of full life. And we declare, God, everything about his kidneys, all the systems in his life. Lord, we thank you for complete healing. We declare it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I see you and your wife both at rest, both at peace, and just luxuriating in the peace of God. God's not only giving you more years, he's giving you good years.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Good years. Good years. Hallelujah. Healthy years. Amen.
I'm told I have fatty liver disease.
Fatty liver disease. First name again?
Tony.
Tony. Lord, we pray for Tony, Lord. We just pray for the healing of that liver. We rebuke the word disease. We rebuke that through the blood of Jesus, and we put your blood over him and against every other lie. We declare, God, that Tony is the recipient of your hand today, and he's receiving health. He's receiving strength today. Your strength in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Whew, and I feel it. Get ready for good news. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
In March, they found a spot on my kidneys.
Okay.
I don't know what it is yet.
She's saying in March, they found a spot on her kidneys. They don't know what it is yet, but we agree. First name again?
Gloria.
Gloria. Lord, we thank you for healing Gloria today. We thank you for brand new brand new kidneys. Whatever this spot is, we have the authority. You said we could tread on serpents and scorpions over all the power of the enemy, and we declare this thing dried up, and we just declare good news. In Jesus' name. And the Lord tells me to tell you to stop worrying. Worrying is a waste of time on any subject, because God says to trust him in everything. And just the Lord just wants to simplify. Stop worrying. Okay. Hallelujah. Every time you want to worry, praise God. Just praising God. All right. Thank you, Lord.
I've been diagnosed with hepatitis.
So, Lord, we agree. We agree in Jesus' name for the complete healing, the wonderful healing, the amazing healing. Thank you, Jesus. 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 We receive, Lord. We receive with her. Man, do I feel the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah.
I have primary biliary cirrhosis, and they can't get the enzyme count down. It's been many years.
Mm-hmm. Cirrhosis where they can't get the enzymes down.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
How long were you secretary here? Long time?
Yeah, it was a long time.
Long time. I remember that. It's so cool. It's so neat that she, this is a good woman right here. Hallelujah. The Lord, we just claim wisdom for the doctors. We claim healing for Judy's body. We just thank you, Lord, for these enzymes, all this that will work. It'll just work. Lord, we just declare today you've sent her here today to get healed, to get whole, to get complete, and Lord, satisfy her. You know, I hear that Psalm 103. The Lord will satisfy your years. Mm-hmm. So get ready to enjoy more.
Yes.
He's taking care of that. And I really feel that confidence. He's taking care of this issue. Your body's going to work on that.
All right.
Thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Wow. And who is the colds and fever person? You need your immune system healed. Did you ever come up? And I need three up here that battle heartburn. You battle a lot of heartburn. And if I can get all three of you up here, or if you've always wanted heartburn. Anyway. Three of you, yeah. So you battle that all the time?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. What about you, bud? All the time? Yeah. All the time. Lord, we bless Crystal. We bless her with healing today. We thank you, Lord, that you're more than enough. And we all in this room, we accept your power. We accept your glory. We accept the virtue of Jesus flowing to her. We just declare, God, the healing power of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God has some divine appointments for you. But the most important thing I hear is the Lord saying things are going to get easier. You've been through battles and battles and more battles, but things are going to get easier. There's some divine appointments coming that when they happen, you're going to say, yep, only God could have designed that. Only God could have settled that. And we receive. So get ready. God's going to do so much, you're not going to be able to stop smiling. You're going to smile till the cows get home. You're going to smile and smile and smile because what God's doing inside you. This is a good season in your life. Yes, it is. Lord, we thank you. Your first name is?
Denise.
Lord, we thank you for Denise. Lord, we thank you for her hair, Lord, today. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the virtue of Jesus Christ flowing, that she doesn't deal with this heartburn anymore, Lord. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. You've spoken truth to some people. I don't know if these are your offspring or who, but it didn't get received real well. But there's like so much good going to come out of this. There's so much peace going to come out of this. And there's so much reconciliation from the Lord toward you and some others. And it's going to be at a higher level of fellowship that you've ever known. And the Lord is pleased because you've been bold to speak out your peace. There's great, great relationships being restored.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
I feel like this with those you love, just some that you know that are close to you, probably part of your family, but it's going to be so cool. Amen.
Thank you.
Heartburn. What's your name?
Bethany.
Mm-hmm. Lord, we bless Bethany today with the healing of this heartburn, Lord. And here's what I hear besides God healing you. You've been a good shoulder for people to cry on. And the Lord loves you. The Bible says, bear one another's burdens. And I see you doing that. And I see you leaning on the Lord. And the Lord is pleased with how you let him flow through you to other people. There's going to be such healing for it, more and more. And as you lean on him, he's going to give you more. He's going to give you more prophetically. He's going to give you more anointing. He's going to give you more to say to different people. And Lord, we thank you for this gift in her. We thank you, Lord, for healing the heartburn. Heal her so much, she'll have to find something else to complain about, God. Amen. Amen. And first name,
Matt.
Lord, we bless Matt today. We thank you for a brand new area here in his heart, Lord, that heartburn, that whatever that is that gets in there. Lord, we just ask you to heal everything. Heal the root of that problem. And Lord, just bless him with pure healing, that this is not an issue in his life anymore. The last 4 years have been so many bumps and hindrances and just stuff going on. But the Lord has you. He has your full attention. And he's going to lead you. It's just like I see a rope just tied to your spirit and the Lord leading. They that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. God is leading you. And you're going to feel God taking more charge. You're going to feel that ability just to release things to him. And the Lord is leading. It's like I see green pastures. This doesn't have anything to do with your golf game. But I see green pastures and just more and more of that lush presence of the Lord. You being at peace, you're his son. They that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. And as you call upon God, God's taking care of a lot of stuff. And it's going to be so simplified the way God works in your life. Hallelujah. 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 Do you have a brother?
Younger brother.
What's going on with him?
He's having some
physical problems.
Issues. His neck. Just had carpal tunnel.
Okay. We just pray for him. What's his name?
Josh.
Lord, we send the word to Josh right now that you'll heal him of all these issues, carpal tunnel and everything else, oh God. We declare him free, 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 free. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Quicken him, Lord, and get him on track with you, oh God, in Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. So, hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't know when I've battled so much as June 5th, this meeting. For days, I just battled, and I couldn't seem to get the mind of the Lord until this morning, and it just became clear. But I know this is a very important word, that if you'll take on this attitude from now on, I'm going to receive.
Yes.
Every day, God is trying to get to me. We think we're trying to get to God. No, God's trying to get to us. And he wants us to receive, whether it's healing, whether it's encouragement, whether it's direction. The Lord is the healer. He's the deliverer. I was preaching. I'm done here, but I'll go a second here. But I was going to preach in Farmington, Missouri one night, and my wife's cousins were coming, and they're both unsaved. I knew if they came to the meeting, they would get saved. They would receive the Lord. I just knew it. But on their way there, and they drove 100 miles, they were looking forward to coming. They were planned. They promised. On the way there, they got a call from their grandchildren, who they had not talked to in 5 years. And they said, we're coming to your house tonight. And they turned the car around and went home. The devil's committed to keep you from receiving.
Oh, yes.
Jesus said, blessed is he who's not offended in me, because if you get offended, you're not receiving. They say if you want to pastor the largest church in the world, just gather up all the spirit-filled people who don't go to church anymore. It's amazing, because so many people have been offended. And I'm saying, if you've been a Christian more than 15 minutes, you're going to have an opportunity to be offended.
Oh, yes.
Because it, the enemy's way is to stop you from receiving. But go to God every day. That's what we do. Go to God every day. God, we are willing. We want to receive. And if you like weakness, I'm your best example. I used to battle depression, embrace depression. And if you want to get depressed, I am a professional. I can help you. But it's like the devil is out there to rob you. We don't have any, you know, the devil has deceived most people that he's not real. And the devil has told most people they're not worthy. Keeps us from receiving. How many people say, I just feel so unworthy? Well, it's a lie from hell. You're not worthy by something you've done, but you're worthy because of the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to pray for my brother and sister over here a second again. First name, brother, is
Tom.
And
Melinda.
Lord, we just thank you again today because I just feel such compassion for you both. But Lord, we just pray for your work in their lives. We pray for the increase of your precious Holy Spirit. And Lord, we thank you that they've come up a long hill. They've come up through a lot of wilderness. But Lord, you're doing a quick thing in their lives. You're sweetening their lives. You're adding to their lives. It's a truly, truly a brand new beginning in their lives together and with you. And Lord, we just see you settling everything, flooding them with peace, flooding them with an assurance, a knowing that if God be for them, who can be against them? In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Man, I just felt like I had to pray that, and you guys be blessed because it's real. You know, I just say to help any of you, my title, if you want to hear it, is Steve. That's my title. I'm nothing but the Holy Spirit's in me, just like he's in you. He wants to use all of us. And there's opportunities all around. Sometimes it's as simple as saying to somebody, could I pray with you? Is there anything you need prayer about? Just as simple as that. But let the Holy Spirit flow through you. Hallelujah. Lord, I've never liked these two. But I thank you, Lord, for the direction you have in their lives. I was just looking at you this morning. I saw they're just so much ahead. There's so much ahead. And Lord, we just thank you for them because they're like, you're like pioneers in God's eyes. You've plowed. You know, when you drive down the interstate, somebody had to build that interstate. That's the way you are. You've pioneered a lot. And God's going to sweeten these next years of your life. Add to them. Hallelujah. I see I don't know how many children you have, but I see everybody fervently turning to the Lord. All of them fervently turning to the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Not just turning to the Lord, but fervently turning to the Lord. Amen. Amen. Wow. Do we serve a good God or not? Yes, 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 yes. Well, I don't know what else to do, but we're in the wonderful presence of God because I feel saturated. I really do. I feel loopy. Before I turn back to Pastor Zach and number one, I always bring my books, but a lot of you are new, so Confronting Jezebel, if you have a control freak in your life, or if you want one, that's one. The other side of control, this book, I put more work into it, and there's more in this book than any. I was an Ahab. That means you're passive, a passive people. Many men are passive. They don't lead. This is a book about getting rid of passivity and how to deal with Jezebels. If you're those who expect nothing are never disappointed. I did have a book, Don't Talk to Me Now, Lord, I'm Trying to Pray. And we've sold out of that one, but and this has gone all over the world. You can hear the voice of God. There's just 10 ways God speaks. A friend of mine, a missionary, wrote this book on forgiveness. I threw a few copies back there. So, again, This is a word from God today to receive. I challenge you to take it as a part of your life. Don't just pray, receive.
Yes.
Don't just pray, marinate. And give God time, because the most important thing that the Lord is emphasizing to his body is to spend time with him. Get to know him. Get familiar with his voice. Everything else is, when he rebuked Martha, Lord, tell my sister to come in here and help me. Don't ever take somebody to Jesus, because he'll let them go. Oh, that went by. But he said, Martha, you're distracted by many things. You don't marinate. You're distracted. Mary has chosen the good part, which will not be taken from her. And so this is the good part today. If I can just get that emblazoned in your mind, God wants you to receive every day. Before we leave, let's pray for Chad and is she here? Or she
left with the baby.
Oh, she's with the baby. Well, we can pray tonight. Either way, they'll be here tonight. Let me pray for Stacy. When I first met Stacy, I see you. Either you were 6 or you were 9. 6. When you pray for a woman, you can't ask her how old she is. So I have to say the next best thing: how much do you weigh? It's dangerous. Yeah. Very dangerous. But Lord, we just pray your blessing. We pray new life. We pray the increase of the sweet Holy Spirit. Lord, we pray direction. We pray, God, the newness of your life and the furthering of your plan. We just thank you, Lord, that you're a faithful God. We just thank you, Jesus, for your person, and we exalt you. And I just feel that the assignment is just to exalt the Lord. Just exalt the Lord. Just exalt the Lord. He'll do the rest. Hallelujah. Man, I feel the Holy Spirit. Wow. So, I am anointed to stop. And so we're going to continue tonight. Pastor will come up and do something spiritual. But tonight at 6:00, and we'll get right into the Lord's business. We're not going to make a long thing, but let the Lord move. Okay? God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Give Brother Steve a hand, would you? Wow. I want to encourage you to heed the word of the Lord. We didn't bring him here just to give him a place to go. He didn't need to do that. But to speak the word of the Lord. And the word for this house right now is receive. So God sent somebody to release his word into our life. And our lives can absolutely be changed. This testimony has been running in me. I just heard from one of my pastor friends in Paducah that just happened this past week. He's been ministering to a family there that was really, really troubled. And he just been pouring into them, and they started receiving, and their lives were absolutely radically changed. Now that doesn't sound much, but pastor had a need, and pastor and his wife, they've been pastoring his church, had one vehicle, and he had been driving the church van to have something to get around in. And because of what God did in that family, they called the pastor up and said, Pastor, we want you to go get you a new car. What do you want? So he thought, well, you know, they just said, go get a car. And he thought, I'll go get something secondhand. So looking around, and then he got messy. What does that mean? They told me to go get a car. And he comes back to them and they said, we don't care what it costs. If you have to order it, whatever you do, we want you to go get it. He fumbled around for a couple days and didn't do nothing. They found out what he wanted, so they went and got it for him. And they bought him a brand new 2022 GMC Yukon, the top of the line car that probably was close to $100,000 on the sticker that was given to him. All because one family received, but he almost missed himself. He almost missed because he was looking at secondhand stuff when they said, get what you want. This is the time to get what you want. Look at your neighbor and say, get what you want. I believe it with all my heart. I want you to stand with me. We're going to bless Brother Steve this morning. We always do. Listen, church, one of the ways I believe in receiving isn't that we come and just say amen, but we pour into them financially, that we see that their needs are met. We don't want to just meet a need. We want to bless. I'm going to ask you to sow the very best seed that you can this morning into Brother Steve's ministry, and we'll see that every dime of it that comes in will go to him. We've watched this too much. I know it works. Our blessing comes by us honoring and receiving. This is part of receiving. I receive the gift that God sent in to speak to my life. So get your offering in hand. If you're making it out to the church, a check, write it out to Christ Church. If you want to give online or do that thing, if they can do that, that QR thing, they'll put it up on the screen so that you can see that. However you want to do it, we want you to give. The buckets are at the doors. Up here, baskets are there. Buckets here. Drop it off as you leave. Tonight, 6 o'clock, invite somebody to come with you. We're going to have a good time. And I don't know about you, we're going to receive some more. Amen? We're going to receive some more. Father, thank you for this great day. Thank you for your goodness and blessing. Thank you for Brother Steve. Father, we thank you for his ministry, for his friendship, for his care, for his love. Father, for watching over us and making sure that we're staying in order. Father, we just bless him and Melody today, God. We pray that there's no want, no lack in their life, and everything they have need of to abound in the name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Be sure to go in the lobby, pick up all of his books so he don't have to take them home. We're so glad all of you here. Good day, everybody. We'll see you at 6 this evening.